So today we will discuss about the last topic of this first chapter in the second module, that is the Coriolis component of acceleration. Coriolis component of acceleration. So till now we have discussed the four bar mechanisms, that is the velocity and acceleration analysis of a four bar mechanism, then a slider crank mechanism, and then also the toggle mechanisms. Now there, the distance between the two points were never changing. That is, when we take a link, when we consider a slider crank mechanism, okay, and when we consider the link, that is the final link, which is having, let us say, this is a link which is connected to a slider, okay. So distance between these two points will never change. In such conditions, we can apply the principles which we have discussed till now. But in some of the mechanisms, just let us say quick return mechanisms, so there what happens is, normally there will be an input link. Let us consider this as OA. This link is connected to a slider, and there is another link which is also having this common point. Let us name it as B dash, and let this be B, this is C, and this is again the slider which moves along its length of stroke, So we know the principle behind the working of quick return mechanisms. So what happens now when I consider this link OC, it is having a slider in between, which not only rotates due to the rotation of the crank, but also this whole link will rotate. OC will rotate. Not only it rotates with the rotation of the crank, but the slider inside this link will also move linearly. So this will sometimes, in any time of the cycle, okay, it may reach this point, it may reach this point, or even this point. So when this condition appears, so the principle which we have applied previously does not work. For all the other links, okay, the same principle applies. That is, again, I will just brief up. So when we consider a link moving with an angular velocity and angular acceleration, so always the velocity vector for this link OA will be perpendicular to this link. And when we consider the acceleration, it has got two components, AC and AT. That is the centripetal component of acceleration and tangential component of acceleration. So centripetal component of acceleration is normally given by V square by R, and tangential component of acceleration is given by alpha into R. So this is the magnitude what we are talking about. So when we come to the directions, so always the centripetal acceleration acts towards the point of rotation, so this is the directional vector for acceleration, that is towards the center of rotation. Now when we consider tangential acceleration, again it will be in a direction perpendicular to the link. So this is what we have learnt. So when these two components, that is the centripetal component and the tangential component, are connected together, so are connected together. So what we obtain finally is the resultant acceleration. So this is what we have learnt already. So let us not discuss about that. Now what is Coriolis component of acceleration? So as I have told you, a condition arises when we have a link which is also having a slider, and the slider is rotating, and the slider is rotating when the link rotates, and also it slides up and down. So there are two motions, okay, relative to the point, fixed point O. So for that, let us just consider a link. So let us just consider a link OA. On this link, consider a point B, which is here considered as the slider. After some point of time, a little point of time, so this link will rotate with some angular velocity. So when I say this is d theta, so now when it reaches a new position OA dash, B not being here will be shifted to, let us say, a point here, a new point, that is E. The slider is not only rotating with the rotating link, but also it is sliding up, and reaches a new position E. So now we have to calculate. So this becomes an arc here. So when we say B has been transformed to a new position E, so our imagination is the B has to move to a new point C. From there, it has to move linearly, and then from there, it has to reach the point E. So let us name this point as D. So it forms an arc now. So let this point, new point, be F. So now we need to find out this arc which gives us the rotation as well as the translation motion of B to move to a new position E. So for that, what I'll do is, again I'll just tell you, when a joint on one link is sliding along another rotating link, okay, such as in some of the quick return mechanisms, the Coriolis component for acceleration has to be calculated. Now let us consider a link OA and a slider B on the link. When the link rotates, the slider with respect to the link also rotates. That is good. But here, along with the rotation of the slider, the slider moves linearly along the link, and it achieves a new position E. That is, position of B changes from B to E while the link is rotated at an angle d theta. In a small time, let us say dt. It is seen that to move from B to E, the slider has to move from its position B to C first, then should move to a position D, and then it should reach E. So let us discuss about the mathematical relation here. So mathematically, if I want to know the arc of the length, length of the arc, let us say arc D, if I want to find out the length of arc D, that will be equal to arc FE minus arc FD. Arc FE minus the arc FD. But as we can see here, arc FD is equal to arc BC. Arc FD is equal to arc BC. So therefore, arc D will be equal to arc FE minus arc BC. Now we know to calculate the length of the arc, formula is R into theta. R is nothing but the length. Okay, so therefore this will be equal to arc, when we consider arc FE, so the length of the link is OF into theta. Theta is d theta. See, this is also d theta. So when I consider arc FE, in order to find out the length of arc FE, so the length of the link is OF into d theta minus, when we want to find out the arc of BC, so the length of the link is OB into d theta. Now d theta is common, let us take it outside. OF minus OB into d theta Now we know that what is OF minus OB. OF minus OB is FB. Is it right? FB. So but what is FB? FB is also equal to this length CD. FB is also equal to CD. So therefore arc DE will be equal to CD into D theta. CD into D theta. Now when we see this CD, okay, it is a translation motion. What we can see here, that is from point B the slider moves to point C, and then it will move to point D linearly with a velocity V, so here CD has translation motion. Therefore the length of CD, or the CD, can be given as V into DT. CD can be given as V into DT. That is the velocity of sliding time into the sliding, velocity of sliding into the time taken. And D theta is the angular displacement, as we know. D theta is the angular displacement, of course, and it is normally given by omega into dt, so therefore CD is equal to V into dt, and d theta is equal to omega into dt. So now substitute this, these two values in the equation. So arc DE will be equal to, CD is V into dt, whereas d theta is omega into dt. So that is V into omega dt square. Now what I'll do is, I'll see, as this arc DE is very small, okay, it can be considered as a chord. So there is no arc at all. So therefore DE is equal to V omega dt square, which is the displacement between point D and E. So now assuming the body at rest here, so we know the equation for displacement, that is S is equal to ut plus half at square. Here, when the body is at rest initially, so this term or the velocity is 0. Velocity is 0. So therefore, s will be equal to half at square. So consider d as initial displacement where initial velocity value is 0. Consider dE as initial displacement where initial velocity value is 0. Therefore, dE, so let this be equation 1. Therefore, dE is equal to half at square without velocity. Velocity is equal to 0. A is the Coriolis component of acceleration here. So let this be equation number 2. Now equate 1 and 2. So half at square is equal to v omega dt square. So t here is small time dt again. So half is dt square is equal to v omega dt square. So dt square gets cancelled. Now the value of the Coriolis component of acceleration A CR is equal to 2 V omega. So whenever you need to find out the Coriolis component of acceleration, this formula will be used. Now we will see the directions. Okay, how exactly the directions we can have. Directions of the Coriolis component. Now let us, I'll just consider a link which is fixed at a point and there is a slider here which is moving upwards with a velocity v, and this link is having an angular acceleration, so having an angular velocity omega in this direction or in the clockwise direction. So for this, the Coriolis the direction of the Coriolis component will be perpendicular to the velocity vector. So now, similarly, if I consider the same link with the slider moving with respect to a fixed point here and having the angular velocity in the clockwise direction, or the link is rotating in the clockwise direction, but the slider is moving with a linear velocity v downwards, so for this the direction of Coriolis component will be perpendicular to the linear velocity, but in this direction. Similarly, if I consider another link or same link with a slider rotating about a fixed point, having angular velocity anti-clockwise or counterclockwise, and the slider is, let us say, moving upwards with a linear velocity v, so the direction of the Coriolis component for this will be in this direction, that is perpendicular to v obviously, but in this direction. So vice versa, then we consider a link rotating about a point, a fixed point in counterclockwise direction, and when the slider is moving downwards with a linear velocity v, then the direction of Coriolis component of acceleration will be like this. Coriolis component of acceleration will be like this. So if this much is understood, we can solve a problem on the Coriolis component of acceleration.